इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. टू गैसेज आर गिवन इन अ कंटेनर. वन इज हीलियम गैस एंड वन इज SO2 गैस. एंड द मास ऑफ हीलियम इज ऑल्सो गिवन 20 ग्राम. सो 20 ग्राम हीलियम डिफ्यूजेस थ्रू अ होल इन 10 सेकेंड्स. सो द मास ऑफ SO2 गैस विल डिफ्यूज इन 20 सेकेंड्स विल बी. एज वी हैव गिवन मास ऑफ हीलियम, सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ हीलियम. सो नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ हीलियम गैस विल बी गिवन मास डिवाइडेड बाय मॉलिकुलर मास. सो इट इज 20/4=5. सी वी हैव टू फाइंड द मास ऑफ SO2 गैस डिफ्यूज थ्रू द सेम होल इन 20 सेकेंड्स. एज वी नो द रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ हीलियम अपॉन रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ SO2 इज स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ मॉलिकुलर मास ऑफ SO2 विच इज 64 बाय मॉलिकुलर मास ऑफ हीलियम विच इज 4. ऑन सॉल्विंग वी गेट 4. सो एज वी नो द रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन इज नंबर ऑफ मोल्स. रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन इज नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ गैस डिफ्यूज पर यूनिट टाइम. एज 5 मोल्स ऑफ हीलियम डिफ्यूज इन 10 सेकेंड्स. सो इट इज 5/10. वी डोंट नो द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ SO2 गैस. लेट एन इज द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ SO2 गैस डिफ्यूज इन 20 सेकेंड्स. सो n/20=4. ऑन सॉल्विंग वी गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ n विच इज 10/4. सो नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ SO2. सो नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ SO2 विल बी नंबर मोल्स ऑफ SO2 विल बी 10/4. सो इट इज 5/2. एज वी नो नंबर ऑफ मोल्स इज गिवन मास बाय मोलर मास. सो मोलर मास ऑफ SO2 इज 64. सो द वेट ऑफ SO2 कम्स हेयर 160 ग्राम. सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज 3 गैसेज इन एयर वी नो. वन इज हाइड्रोजन, वन इज ऑक्सीजन एंड वन इज नाइट्रोजन. एंड देयर मॉलिकुलर मासेज आर गिवन 2 ग्राम, 32 ग्राम एंड 28 ग्राम. वी हैव टू फाइंड द ऑर्डर ऑफ एयर कमिंग फ्रॉम द बैलून एट फास्टर रेट. एज वी नो दैट द रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ एनी गैस एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ मॉलिकुलर मास. अ गैस विद हाई मॉलिकुलर मास विल हैव स्लो रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन एंड अ गैस विद लो मॉलिकुलर मास विल हैव हाई रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन. सो एज मॉलिकुलर मास ऑफ H2, N2 एंड O2 इज 2 ग्राम, 28 ग्राम एंड 32 ग्राम. सो स्मॉलर मॉलिकुलर मास फॉर हाइड्रोजन गैस, देयरफॉर फास्टर इज द रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन फॉर हाइड्रोजन. एज O2 हैज हाई मॉलिकुलर मास, सो O2 विल हैव स्लो रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन. सो द ऑर्डर इज H2, N2 एंड O2. सो दिस इज द करेक्ट ऑर्डर ऑफ एयर कमिंग फ्रॉम द बैलून. सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अ सिलिंड्रिकल कंटेनर इज गिवन. सिलिंड्रिकल कंटेनर इज गिवन एंड थ्रू टू एंड्स ऑफ अ सिलिंड्रिकल कंटेनर थ्रू वन एंड अमोनिया गैस इज पास एंड थ्रू अनदर एंड HCl गैस इज पास. द क्वेश्चन इज एट विच पॉइंट वाइट फ्यूम्स विल अपीयर फर्स्ट. वाइट फ्यूम्स विल अपीयर फर्स्ट. एज वी नो व्हेन अमोनिया एंड HCl कंबाइंस इट फॉर्म्स NH4Cl सॉलिड. सो बेसिकली इट फॉर्म्स अमोनियम क्लोराइड सॉलिड विद वाइट फ्यूम्स. सो एज वी नो दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन, रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ मॉलिकुलर मास. रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ मॉलिकुलर मास. अ गैस विद लो मॉलिकुलर मास, अ गैस विद लो मॉलिकुलर मास विल हैव हाई रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन. सो आउट ऑफ दीज टू गैस, वन इज अमोनिया एंड वन इज HCl. अमोनिया हैज लो मॉलिकुलर मास, सो रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ अमोनिया विल बी फास्टर. दिस इज ए पॉइंट, बी इज द मिड पॉइंट एंड सी इज द पॉइंट नियर बाय HCl. सो डेफिनेटली द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ NHCl विल बी अवे फ्रॉम द पॉइंट बी एंड towards the HCl end, as rate of diffusion of NCl is more than the rate of diffusion of HCl. So, as due to small molecular mass, ammonia has high rate of diffusion, so ammonia gas will move faster. So ammonia will move faster. When ammonia will move faster, then the formation of NH4Cl will be near to the end of HCl. And near to the end of HCl, which point is present? The point C is present. So it is formed at point C. So option B is correct. As rate of diffusion of NH3 is more than diffusion of HCl. See the next question. The next question is, as the next question is basically also on the rate of diffusion. See, what is the next question? The next question is, again cylindrical container is given. So cylindrical container is given, and the two ends of cylindrical container are separated by 100 cm apart. Through one end hydrogen gases pass, and through other end oxygen gases pass. Molecular mass of H2 is 2 gram, and molecular mass of O2 is 32 gram. So two gases are passed through two ends of a cylindrical container. We have to find the distance. We have to find the distance from H2 end. So we have to find the distance from H2 end at which first drop of liquid will appear. So when H2 and O2 reacts, and H2 and O2 reacts, it forms water. As molecular mass of H2 is smaller than O2, it means H2 will have faster rate of diffusion. So it is clear that the first drop of liquid water will form near the end of O2. Why near the end of O2? Because the rate of diffusion of H2 is faster. But we have to find the distance from H2 end. Let the distance from H2 end is x, then distance from O2 end will be 100 minus x. So the distance from O2 end will be 100 minus x. See. So we have let from this end hydrogen is passed, and from this end oxygen is passed. So the point at which formation of water takes place is at x distance from H2 end and 100 minus x from O2 end. As we know, the rate of diffusion of H2 by rate of diffusion of O2 is equal to square root of molecular mass of O2 by H2. It comes 4. So rate of diffusion is 4. As we know, rate of diffusion in terms of distance by time. So distance traveled by H2 is x. Distance traveled by H2 is x in time t. So when H2 travels x distance, then O2 will travel 100 minus x. So rate of diffusion of O2 will be 100 minus x, and in the same time, which is t. So now t will cancel out. It comes x upon 100 minus x equal to 4. When we solve 400 minus 4x equal to x, so the x is 80. So the formation of water at this point, which is 80 cm away from hydrogen end and 20 cm away from oxygen end. See the next case. In next case, what is given there? We have to find the rate of diffusion of carbon monoxide with a mixture of helium and CH4 in 3:1 ratio under similar condition. See, the mole fraction of CH4 will be 3/3+1, that is 3/4, while the mole fraction of CH4 gas will be 1/1+3, means 4. As rate of diffusion of CO with mixture of gas we have to find. So we have to find for mixture of gas we find average molecular mass. So for mixture of gas we find average molecular mass, and the formula of average molecular mass is mole fraction of first gas इनटू मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ फर्स्ट गैस प्लस मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकंड गैस इनटू मोलर मास ऑफ सेकंड गैस. सी व्हाट इज द एवरेज मास ऑफ दिस मिक्सचर ऑफ हीलियम एंड CH4. सो मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ हीलियम इज 3/4 एंड मोलर मास ऑफ हीलियम इज 4 एंड मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ CH4 विल 1/4 एंड मॉलिकुलर मास ऑफ CH4 इज 16. सो द एवरेज मॉलिकुलर मास कम्स हियर 7. नाउ वी हैव टू कंपेयर द रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड विद दिस मिक्सचर. सो द रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ CO अपॉन रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ मिक्सचर ऑफ गैस will be equal to square root of the molecular mass of mixture is how much 7 we have calculated and the molecular mass of CO is 12 + 16 = 28. So the rate of diffusion comes out 1/2. See the next case. The next case is the first case what we have discussed. In first case the pressure is constant. See, when the pressure is different, so when the pressure is variable, when the pressure is variable, then how we calculate the rate of diffusion. So the first container in which gas 1 is present at pressure P1 and molecular mass is M1, and in the second container gas G2 is present with pressure P2 and molecular mass M2. See, when the pressure is different, then rate of diffusion of gas also depends on the pressure of gas. So rate of diffusion varies directly proportional to the pressure of gas. And also we note that the rate of diffusion according to Gram's law of diffusion is inversely proportional to square root of molecular mass. So when we compare for two gases, the rate of diffusion will be, so R1 will be P1 upon square root of M1, and R2 will be P2 upon square root of M2, as temperature is same. Now we will take the ratio. When we take ratio, then rate of diffusion for variable pressure will be R1 upon R2. This is for variable pressure, if pressure is varying. So R1 by R2 will be equal to P1 by P2 into root of M2 by M1. So this condition is for variable pressure. This condition is for variable pressure. Now we will discuss some questions over all gas laws. See question number 1. Question number 1 is, container is given and gas is present in a container with volume of 10 liter and the container is heated at 27 degrees Celsius. See, the question is, what will be the volume of gas? What will be the volume of gas if container is heated to 127 degrees Celsius? If container is heated to 127 degrees Celsius. See, as we know, according to ideal gas equation, PV equal to nRT. As there is no gas molecule is escaping from the container, means number of moles will remain constant and R is a gas constant. Also pressure is not changing, means pressure is also constant. So only two terms are variable. We have to find the new volume. Initial volume is given. We are heating first at 27. Now temperature is changing, means only volume and temperature terms are changing, means in this case volume according to this equation is proportional to temperature. So we will say V1 by T1 equal to V2 by T2. V1 is given how much? V1 is 10 liter and T1 is how much? T1 is 300 Kelvin. And V2 is how much? V2 is given there, which is we have to find T2 in Kelvin. So in Kelvin it will be 127 plus 273 equal to 400 Kelvin. So now solving, we get the final volume, which is 33.3. So this is the final volume. It means increase in volume. How much? From 10 to 33.3. So 3.3 liter increase in the volume. See the next question. The next question is, again, see what is the next question. The question is volume of a gas. Question is the volume of a gas at 40 is 40 liter. The volume of a gas is 40 liter at 3 degree Celsius when temperature is 3 degree Celsius. So when temperature is increased by 50 degree Celsius, so now we are changing the temperature. On changing the temperature, as temperature increased by 50 degree Celsius, so volume increases by 25%. Volume increases by 25%. Calculate the value of T. As we can see that in this question, pressure is constant because pressure is not varying, and also number of moles is also constant. Now again apply the equation. The equation is PV equal to nRT. So PV equal to nRT, number of moles is constant, we know R is gas constant, and pressure in this case is also constant. It means volume is varying directly proportional to temperature. So question is again in the form of Charles law. Now we can say that V is proportional to T, means V1 upon T1 will be equal to V2 upon T2. See how. If V1, we are given 40 liter. So V2 is, the question, when temperature increases by 50 degree Celsius, volume increases by 25%. It means V2 will be initial volume plus 25% of its initial volume, as it is increases by 25%. So initial volume is how much? 40 plus 25% of initial volume is 40 again. So V2 becomes 50 liter. And 40 liter volume is at 3 degree Celsius. It means in Kelvin, it will be T plus 273. Now, temperature increased by 50 degree Celsius. So initial temperature is T plus 273. So final temperature will be T plus 273 plus 50. Because temperature increased by 50 degree Celsius. So the T2 is the final temperature. Now we have equation V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. See. So V1 is given how much? V1 is 40 liter. V2 we have calculated 50 liter. And T1 is T plus 273. And T2 we have calculated T plus 323. On solving, we get temperature equal to minus 273, or Kelvin it will be 200 Kelvin. So this is the correct answer. See the next question. The next question is, see the next question. The next question is, this is the frictionless piston in a cylinder. As temperature is constant, this is the internal pressure applied by gas on the piston, and this is the external pressure applied by the atmosphere onto piston. So the question is, what will be the change in volume? What will the change in volume if pressure is increased by 4 times? If pressure is increased by 4 times. See, the question is basically, pressure increased by 4 times. As in this question, number of moles is constant. And R is also a gas constant. So basically, pressure is changing and we have to find change in volume. It means PV equal to, as temperature is also constant, because temperature is not varying, so temperature is also constant. It means PV equal to constant. Now apply. P1 V1 equal to P2 V2. If initial pressure is P1 and volume is V1, now the pressure becomes 4 times. So P2 will be 4P1. So volume will be V2. Now when we solve, V2 becomes V1 by 4. So basically final volume becomes 1 by 4 times of its initial volume. See the next question. Now the next question is, see the next question is, the question is volume of a gas cylinder containing 10 marbles. So basically a cylinder with gas also containing 10 marbles. And the gas is 1 liter and the gas is 1 liter. So gas is given 1 liter at 2 atmospheric pressure. At 2 atmospheric pressure. If pressure is increased to 4 atm, the volume becomes 625 ml. So the volume becomes 625 ml. We have to calculate the volume of each marble which is present in the container. See, this is the system. Like, we have initial 1 liter means 1000 ml, and this 1000 ml at a pressure of 2 atm. Now the final volume becomes from 1000 to 625, and pressure becomes from 2 atm to 4. As we can see that number of moles is not changing, means number of moles is constant. Also temperature is constant. See, the question is, this is the volume initial and final when there are 10 marbles. When there are 10 marbles also. And we don't know the volume of marble. So we have to find the volume of each marble. See, so basically this 1000 ml, the volume initial given is the volume of gas, plus, if the volume of each marble is V, and how many marbles are present? 10. So this 1000 ml is the volume of gas plus the volume of 10 marbles, 10 into V. So the volume of gas will be how much? The volume of gas will be 1000 minus 10 V. So this is the initial volume of gas. Now volume becomes 625. So we can say 625 will be again equal to volume of gas plus the volume of 10 marbles. So now the final volume of gas will become how much? It is also 625 minus 10V. So we can say that now we have initial volume of gas and also we have final volume of gas. And also it is given the initial pressure of gas, which is 2 atm, and final pressure of gas, which is 4 atm. As number of moles is constant, temperature is also constant. So apply PV equal to nRT. When we apply PV equal to nRT, number of moles is constant, R is also constant, and temperature is also constant. So PV equal to constant. Again, equation convert into Boyle's law. So now we can apply the equation V1 initial pressure, initial volume equal to P2 into V2. We have P1 2 atm. We have V1 how much? 1000 minus 10V. And V2 how much? 625 minus 10V. So now apply the equation. Now when we apply the equation, it becomes P1 into V1 equal to P2 into V2. Now putting the volume comes 25 ml. It means the volume of each marble is equal to how much? 25 ml. See the next question. The next question is, the next question is 5.6 liter of SOX gas is given. So basically SOX, we don't know the molecule, we don't know the atomicity of oxygen. So 5.6 liter of SOX gas has mass of 20 gram and 1 atmosphere pressure and 273 Kelvin temperature. We have to find the value of X. See, we know number of moles of this gas. number of moles of this gas. As we know, number of moles is volume of gas divided by 22.4 liter. So number of moles will be volume of gas divided by 22.4. So number of moles of gas is how much? As volume of gas is given 5.6 liter. So 5.6 divided by 22.4. So it is equal to 1/4. And also we know number of moles is given mass by molecular mass. Given mass is also given. How much? 20 gram. So number of moles is W by M, and also number of moles Vg by 22.4. So now we can equate this. So 5.6 by 22.4 equal to given mass 20 by M is the molecular mass. So molecular mass of gas is 80 gram. So this is the molecular mass of which gas? SOx gas. So this is the molecular mass of which gas? SOx gas. As we can see that in this gas, sulfur is present, and the molecular mass of sulfur is how much? 32. And molecular mass of oxygen is 16. How many atoms of oxygen are present? X. So 16 into X. And total molecular mass of this gas we have calculated 80. So equal to 80. Now when we solve, 16x equal to 48. So X comes out how much? 3. So the atomicity of X is 3. So gas will be SO3. See the next question. The next question is again, If a certain mass of a gas occupies 20 liter, so volume is given 20 liter at 27 degree Celsius. So temperature is 27 degree Celsius means 300 Kelvin at 2 atm pressure. Pressure is 2 atm. The question is, what will be the volume of same mass of a gas at 27 degree Celsius means temperature is changing. See, pressure is also changing from 2 atm to 1 atm. As we know that PV equal to nRT. PV equal to nRT. See, in this case, we have to find the volume. So we have to find volume. Number of moles of gas is constant. R is constant. So pressure is changing, temperature is changing. Means PV by T equal to constant. PV by T equal to constant. So we can apply. As N is constant, R is constant, pressure changing, temperature changing, and we have to find volume. Means volume is also changing. So PV by T K equal to constant. Now we can apply P1 V1 upon T1 equal to P2 V2 upon T2. See. So when we apply P1 V1 upon T1 equal to P2 V2 upon T2. So pressure P1 is given how much? P1 is given 2 atm. So P1 is 2 atm. And V1 is given how much? 20 liter. And T1 is given how much? T1 is 27 means 300 Kelvin. So P1 V1 by T1. Now P2 pressure becomes how much? P2 is given 1 atm. So P2 is 1 atm. And we have to find V2. And T2 becomes how much? 127. Means 127 plus 273 equal to 400 Kelvin. So T2 is 400 Kelvin. Apply P1 V1 by T1 equal to P2 V2 by T2. So P1 is how much? P1 is 2 atm. And V1 is how much? 20. And T1 is how much? 300. P2 is given how much? 2. P2 is given 1 atm. And we have to calculate V2. And T2 is how much? 400 Kelvin. On solving, we get volume is 53.3 liter. So on changing the conditions, volume of a gas increasing from 20 liter to 53.3 liter.